I mean this for your members, but also, you know, for labor and working families in general. How do we rebuild coming out of this in a way that is actually fair and just and create some sense of security for people and lets, you know, folks live in some dignity?
Is, you know, there's going to be, have to be a lot of federal support. There's going to have to be a lot of money going into companies, into, I mean, right now there's a, there's some bills proposed that would actually have employers keep their employees, and the federal government would help fund that and keep them working, keep them on their health care, keep their paycheck coming. Things like that could help for, especially for the short term, but for the long term, there's going to have to be some bailouts, really. There's going to, for some of these companies that are not going to potentially survive this economy, and the economy is even going to get worse. And then you're talking about pension plans. Let's not even just talk about the union pension plans. Let's talk about state pension plans, the MBTA pension plan, and so on. Those are going to take a real big hit here, and that a lot of people's futures are in that. You can't just all of a sudden change direction when you're later in life and you've been planning on that pension.
Yeah, people have been doing the right thing, right? They've been doing the thing we've told them to do. Work hard, pay into the system, and you'll, you know, have a dignified retirement.
Exactly.
How do you envision, because obviously we need companies and jobs to exist and be stable in order to pay people, but then we're seeing some examples of money going to big companies, and it doesn't make it into the hands of the workers, which was the whole damn point to begin with. So how do you structure those bailouts in a way that's actually worker-centered?
Oh, it's president saying throwing $1,200 at somebody. What does $1,200 do? You need to make sure that their job is secure, and at the end of this, that they have a job to go back to that provides them with health care, provides them with security. That's where we need the money, and we need assurances that it's going to that and not in the pockets of CEOs and so on.